Hello everybody and welcome to another video in my series for scenery building for MSFS 2020. Today I'm going to talk about managing the community folder. I have put a significant amount of time into making videos to teach how to add custom scenery through SDK. Scenery files can become an issue though, but it depends upon how involved you get into making scenery. Once I started making scenery files, I enhanced most every location I enjoyed flying. I brought in many Earth to MSFS files to improve locations with standard AI-generated scenery by adding the 3D aerial photogrammetry. After several months of making scenery files, I started to notice MSFS 2020 was taking longer and longer to load. At one point, the simulator was taking 20 plus minutes to start. And suddenly it occurred to me that all of my added scenery files were slowing down the loading process. I will step through the process I use to solve the loading issues and better manage my community folder. I can't say with certainty how many scenery files that I have built, but I do know I built in the neighborhood of 400 scenery files. That is a very large amount of files to keep in the community folder. It certainly will slow down the loading of the simulator. And now I'm going to show you what my community folder looks like right at this moment. Here is the community folder, and you will notice that I use AIG traffic. So AIG is in my community folder. I use the FS2 crew pushback, and you see that in my community folder. I also use Navigraph, and you can see Navigraph in my community folder. I'm presently flying the PMG 737-700, and so you see PMG in my community folder. And that's all you see in my community folder. I built a separate scenery folder, which I keep on my D drive on my computer. And I organized all of my files. So for example, if I click on Global Scenery, inside of the Global Scenery are mods that I run most of the time, if not all of the time. And I have an International folder, which simply has Aruba and St. Martin, the only two locations outside of the United States that I've added scenery work to. I have a folder for liveries, and then from that point, I organize this folder based on states within the United States. As you can see, Alabama, Arizona, Arkansas, California, and so it goes. I'm from Kentucky and now live in Tennessee. So if I take a look at Tennessee, this will give you an example how I organize things. Inside of Tennessee are the major cities that I fly over. There's Chattanooga, the Knoxville, Tennessee area, Memphis, Nashville, where I live, and the Smoky Mountain areas. If I look in Nashville, I primarily make a folder for lights and a folder for earth. I have one for bridges where I replace the ugly bridges around Nashville. I have one for earth. And inside the earth folder, I have the different folders for the different cities around the Nashville area. And then in lights, I have a lot of lights. I believe I have around 40 light packages just for Nashville. So this is how I organize my scenery by states and by cities. And none of these files are in my community folder. This is the tool that I use. And maybe many of you already have this tool. It's called MSFS Add-on Linker. And how this tool works is once you load the tool, you will point the tool to your scenery folder. And then you will point it to your community folder. So over here are the files that are currently in my community folder. Over here are all the folders and files in the folder that I just showed you. And you can see it's lined up absolutely the same. So for example, if I want to fly from Nashville to Boston, then I would open up Massachusetts. I would click on Boston and I would pull in the files that I want. Typically, I would use all the Boston files, so I would just tick on Boston. I can't show you because this doesn't work with the simulator running. Then I would go down to Tennessee, find Nashville, and highlight the files I want moved in my community folder from Nashville. Something else I might do, for example, if I'm flying from Nashville to Boston, I do know the route is going to take me over Charleston, West Virginia. So most likely I will go to West Virginia, find Charleston, and pick up the light files for Charleston so I can see the city lit up as I fly over, particularly at night. During the daytime, it doesn't matter, but at nighttime, it's pretty cool to see cities that you've lit up as you fly over them. So I do recommend that you get the MSFS add-on linker, and I do recommend that you organize your scenery files, because if you continue to poke scenery files in the community folder, you're eventually going to have slow load times and potentially see crashes to desktop. This is just a short video that I put out to help you guys manage all of your files and folders and show you a tool that might make it a little more helpful. If you have any questions, feel free to leave your questions. If you like this video, give me a like and a subscribe. I want to personally thank all of my subscribers and thank all of you that showed up to see this today. This is Patriot 6 and see you soon.